Hello everyone! 1月2月は受験試験も本番の時期、しっかりと体調を整えて臨みましょう。インタートーマスでは各種直前対策のご相談も受けたまわっております。最後まで諦めず、より良い結果をつかみ取りましょう。 One step ahead!
Hello everyone! Welcome back to PR2! Today, I am going to talk about food loss in vulnerable countries and food waste in the privileged countries. Let's begin!Food loss in the least privileged countries is devastating. For example, the value of post-harvest food loss in sub-Saharan Africa is more than what the region receives in food assistance. And around the world, over 50% of the hungriest people are farmers in poor rural areas who tend fields of 5 acres or less.They invest so many of their precious resources into growing, harvesting, processing, packing, and storing their food. But without the right systems and resources, much of their harvest is lost, thereby perpetuating their hunger. That's why countries that face food loss aren't wasting nearly as much food as the rest of us. Food is wasted in the least vulnerable places. If you live in the United States or another high-income country, you likely witness food waste every single day.Because food here is relatively abundant and inexpensive, most of it's wasted at the consumer level after it travels from where it's grown to the place it's purchased. Think pizza crusts, leftovers, and wilted greens. But food waste in high-income countries can also happen at the producer level. For example, mishapen or surplus produce that gets thrown out by farms isn't considered food loss just because it's pre-consumer.It's classified as waste too, because it's discarded when it's still perfectly edible. That's all for today. See you!